Welcome back, this is Coda, about to head into our final mission before we switch over to day 11, and I think I should get the achieve as soon as I finish this mission. It's been a long journey. So looking at my characters, I sold off and stuff. He has, all the characters have, I think, a cloak, a stim, and my non-Dr. Zoo characters have an EMP and a buster chip. He has an extra stim and the econ chip. All my characters actually have weapons now, since I just bought the flurry gun last mission. And Nika, since she can attack twice, she can use the flurry twice in that one turn, since even though it says it's one turn per mission, you can actually fire it multiple times during that turn and the flurry gun still works. That being the case, I think everything's pretty much set. I'm gonna be diving into the security dispatch. A couple reasons. One is I want to actually just finish this thing, so I need 10 hours. And of the ones that are 10 hours or more away, this is the most attractive one. It's a K&O. I don't really necessarily need an extra item, which will drop from the security dispatch, but whatever. I'm not gonna have my vault access card here. Is that a mistake? If this is gonna blow fish, then this is gonna blow back. But what's the chance of that happening, right?
This is a regional security office.
All right. Let's see if I can't.
Infiltration successful.
Show how this is done. Oh, and I'm using a new mic, so if you have any.
All
right, that's fine. You guys have any issues with the audio, just let me know. Alright, Dr. Zoo does have the econ chip, although it might be better for me to pass off the econ chip to her. Okay, she's full of stuff, so maybe she needs to dump off some stuff to her. Here. Since the item cooldowns are a little higher, I need to be careful about when I deploy, because I might not necessarily be able to get it back anytime soon. Or I won't be able to redeploy if necessary. This is level 1 as well, so no big difference in using one versus the other. It's a pretty high likelihood that this thing will get spotted here. I could start stimming this turn, which I think might be feasible. Stim and cloak this turn. Guess there's no real hurry. No, I'll stim and cloak this turn, I think. I kind of like getting as much accomplished in the first turn as possible. So here I'm just going to enter the room. The stim is going to last me 2 turns. I can tag this guy, but then I'd be uncloaked if I do. I could go here and not peek. I could also stim this agent and then head over. Alright, so this thing is, this turret is at 4. This does mean I could hammer this thing, or alternatively use my buster chip on her. I might want to have gotten power from that. So if I use hammer, then that does prevent me from. I don't think I'm gonna use hammer here. I think I'm gonna just stim. Get over here. Get more action points that way. So this room leads to this room. I can go all the way here, not open the door and peek inside. I could even go here, steal from him. Let's see. So here, 4 action points. 1. Let's see, this thing was a move by 2, so this thing is the next time I move diagonally will cost 1. So if I go here, I have 4 action points. 1, 2, 3. And I can do one last peek. That seems reasonable. Oh, she does have a power server, doesn't she? Oh, no, she doesn't. Okay. I'll go ahead and get some credits here. Everyone besides Banks has the torque injectors. So she can't actually get here. Oh, there's another door this way. Oh, wow. Okay. Did not notice that. So, unfortunately, if I go here and peek, I won't be able to see his patrol. He's an Omni, so he will be patrolling. Technically, if he patrols and goes to here, it's going to be bad for me. Yeah, I think this is necessary. Yeah. Okay. So that does mean that... what does that mean? That means that I could... He's gonna be in front of the door. So I'm kind of barricaded from going to the door here. I could get her here. She wouldn't be seen. And the next turn go here. He stands here, so it's unlikely that there's a guard that goes all the way to here. So I could move into this room and right here maybe. There's unlikely that a guard all goes here as well. And I could put down 2 servers in this room. Okay, so if I were to place the servers would probably be best placed like around the corner here and maybe here. Does she have any servers? She does have a server. So if I place a server here, actually, like, if I place the servers here, here, and here, well, Banks wouldn't be able to do that. Banks would have to go here. I could wait to find where the exit is before I do that. Before I drop down my servers, I mean. You know what? I think I might just wait to drop down the servers. It's not like this thing's gonna really kill my power quite yet. Yeah, okay. This does unfortunately mean that I didn't really use my cooldowns for this. This is a really awkward spot. I think I could stim here. Just to see what's here. Okay, so there's some guy here. Okay, and he would have spotted me there. So I could go here. This would be safe. I could go here. This would also be safe. Oh wow, this guy goes all the way here. So I would not have been safe if I just went there. I would be safe if I go here. But then what would happen? In the following turn, I could steal from him. But then I wouldn't be able to move past this thing. Alternatively, I could, like, drop an EMP right here. That would break his shields and he would stop. I could also stim here. That would cost 5 power. So she can swing over here. Next turn, this guy goes all the way here. I think I might have her go here, cloak. Yeah, let's just use some cooldowns here. What is the cooldown for my stem? 6 and 10, okay. So let's go ahead and cloak. Level, whoa, nilly. Wow, that's a lot. Okay, so which one of these can I do this turn effectively? This power supply is Y5. Okay, so this is a 7 power. I have one buster chip, so 7 means I could possibly do like a hammer plus a hunter right now. Hammer plus hunter. That means I could get like a couple action points, so I could then move over here and possibly use something for that. He can't get in through here until there's some more power, so let's see. What if I wanted to like get power here and then go here? Okay, so I can't do that because it goes here. Diagonally, I can only move one. Alright, so no power from there. I sorta, which does this go to? This is Y5? I don't know what Y5 does, actually. There probably is like a beam somewhere around here. I think what I want here is just to hammer this thing. All right, so that means I can move this gal a little farther. I can move her up here and then have her use the buster chip on this thing. And again, that gave me slightly more action points as well. Alright, I see one more. Well, I could go to where he's at. And I could go to where he's at. There doesn't seem to be a whole lot of. Maybe I just want to drop down a couple of servers here. Like just go over here, drop them down. And then, at least that way, I'll have some power for the next few turns. I'll have to come back to this room, I guess. Which way is quicker? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So he'd use up all his action points going this way. This way is slightly closer. There's almost no way that a guard would be able to see these two spots unless they had some weird, really weird. Padding. So go here, drop these two, then go here, steal from him, and maybe sideways here. Yeah, really sort of want to get some power here. And this will give me like 4 power per turn, which will be really useful. Do I want to maybe hack, put a parasite on something, like put a parasite on their shields here, so that they don't move around so much. Also put a parasite on this thing. So putting parasites on their shields means I have to wait a few turns. Yeah, I guess I'll put parasites on both their shields. I think she can sidestep this. Open this door. So, my guess is next turn she'll be entering this room. So she probably does want to stay on this side. The closest spot to this thing that is safe is possibly here. It's not safe if there's a patrol here. Never mind. So this thing looks okay. And this thing might be safe right here. But this thing is slightly safer, and I think it's the same distance. One, two, three, let's see, one, two, and a diagonal, one, two, and a straight, okay. I'm not gonna open this door because this guy would see that. Well, actually, let me think about that. Do I care if he actually goes into this room? Probably not, right? I mean, he's gonna be... he's going to be just in this room. The following turn, he's going to come up. No, I guess I don't really care. I want to... the thing here is I want to move as far as I can with my cloak. Alright, so this thing is going to be, unfortunately... might have to drop down EMP, but next turn it looks like I'll be going here, opening this door, possibly coming back. And then lastly, let's go ahead and peek to see. Well, I mean, I'll see his movement. I hear a camera. Like, maybe around there. I think I'll... it would be interesting if there was a... oh, there he is. If there was a... an enemy that actually saw through invisibility. That would be pretty powerful given the current state of cloak usage.
Investigating area.
Alright, so he's gonna actually see me open this door as well. Alright, so this camera is stationary. Oh, I could have used the buster chip on this thing? Oh wow. No, that's wrong. I was looking at the wrong character. Okay. If I get stuck in here, this is going to be pretty bad, but I should be alright.
Did you see that?
Okay, so this is the K&O. I think this is the exit. So if I peek in here, I can just come back out. Okay, yeah. I'm pretty sure this is the exit. So I open this door, he's gonna come this way. I'm just gonna come back here and hopefully do something to this safe next turn. Alright. I could even tag him this turn and he wouldn't be able to detect this. Why did he only move this far? I thought I saw him move all the way over here. Or was that this guard? Oh, that was this guard, okay. This guy. EMP vulnerable, but he has 7 on him. This guy's gonna be a tough nut to curl. He doesn't have a buster chip. If I do an EMP, it's not gonna work either. This might require a hammer, him being stemmed up, and then a hammer and maybe EMP. Alright, so let's first figure out his movement. Okay, so he's gonna go there. This should be safe. Alright, this. Oops. This thing right here suggests that there's a vendor. What is this layout? Is there a possibility there's a camera right there? Alright, there's some. Okay. So there's no camera here. I think there might still be a camera there. And there's still a possibility that I haven't. There's maybe even guards in this room that I haven't detected. Alright, there's power to be had here. A 2 and a 2. I can even get both of those powers if I wanted to. I could use my buster chip on this thing, and that would give me some action points. Which one is most worthy? I think power this way leaves me a little open to guards. This way I can get a little more action points as well. Ho ho ho. There we go. This guy's almost certainly patrolling from here to here, I think. Um, Yeah, I think I need to spend an action point to see where he goes. So I could move here, steal from him, and then go back right here. Or I could go over here. Okay, so which way do I want to go? Level 4. I could EMP this. I could hunter this. Parasite it. This thing I can just wait on. I mean, I'm gonna be exiting this way, so I should have plenty of cooldowns to break level 4 next whenever I exit this level. This thing, I can move him here. I could also maybe even go here, open the door, and then go here. I don't know if he'd spot this thing right here. He could also even possibly stem this turn and cloak himself. It's possible that there's nothing on this side, actually. Quite possible. I haven't stemmed her yet. Yeah, actually, you know what? Maybe all I need to do is cross this area, check it out, and then come back through here. If there's nothing over here, then I don't have to deal with this at all. I should be able to have enough action points to stem here. Well, that might have been a mistake there. I might have wanted to go diagonally. So I could go here and then come back here. Again, this thing is kind of barricading me from further going this way, but I could. How badly do I even want this power? Almost certainly gonna have to stem here. Power will be one power for eight, one movement for eight power. Get power here and then wrap around. This girl probably does need to go over here to unlock this thing. Yeah, there's no. This guy's just facing the absolute worst direction. Alternatively, I could make some sort of movement where he goes here with stem, gets over here. So we need to do that. Okay. I think I want to just get power here. And I... Oh shit. I wanted to have... No, I do want to stem this turn. And I do want to cloak when I stem. So I go here, stem, get past this camera drone to here, then next turn do this stuff, yeah. Actually, I'm not sure if whether or not I wanted to pick these up. I think I probably did want to pick those up, actually. It's alright. This allows me to... Well, what the hell? What the hell? Does he have... He doesn't have net downlink. Alright. That blows. So what this means is I can get to, like... Actually, let me double check this. So she's gonna have to go back through here. Alright, so he gets to go all the way to here, maybe? Maybe here? She gets to go... She gets to go to here, probably. Actually, where do I want him to end up? Like, I could end up here, I could end here. Guess I don't really want him to end up in the middle of the room. So this padding is this way. I mean, I guess ending up in the middle of the room is not the worst. Unless there's a camera there. Is there a camera there? No, it doesn't look like it. So if I end up right here, next turn I can move towards this thing. Alright. Question is, do I want to have her swing over here? No, she can't do that. I could have her move over here and have, like, Banks backtrack to unlock this door. The issue there is I'm not sure if this guy... I'm pretty sure this guy ends here and then goes back this way. If this guy ends his turn and goes back this way, I probably just want her to be next to the door and swing over here. She doesn't have enough space though, I don't think. Does not have enough space to get these servers. Guess that's not strictly necessary that I have her pick it up. But most likely she'll be going this way. Alright, for her, I could go here. Hon, why didn't I check this nanofab? What the fuck was I thinking? I can go here, check it out. And I can even go, yeah, this is probably a safe spot. It's okay. It's not the safest spot. Torque injectors, which would be great if... Actually, all my guys, no. If I could get rid of this anatomy analysis, I would. I think I really want a net downlink for him, but all my other characters have torque injectors, so... I do actually want this Buster chip. And I think I would throw away like an EMP pack for it. I find that these are just super useful. EMPs are pretty useful. Do I want to throw this thing away for it, or do I want to keep it? I guess I'll keep it for now. Alright, and I haven't used seed this turn yet, right? Okay. I don't need that. If I use seed on this thing and then maybe... do I want to hack the server terminal maybe? Pretty sure there's no programs I want though. I could also... Okay, so this is 7. I could just lockpick this thing a few times. Or also I could use Hunter on this thing. Yeah. I'm not sure that he's going to be able to get all the way over here. Not sure if I really want to do that. Yeah, this is fine. This is a little insecure. There's a guard that goes through this door. And, like, right in front of this thing.
Investigating area. Nothing.
It doesn't close the door. Alright, I'm gonna start by tagging this guy. Whoa. Tag. Do not kill. That gives me 3 action points at the cost of 1 power. My newfound Buster chip on that. Still looking for the exit card here. Oh wow, another door. Okay. Chance that there's some camera here. Alright, so this should be safe. Okay. So this thing is the security dispatch. It looks like I do need to shut down this generator in order for me to access it. Let's see where this guy goes. Alright, he's going backwards. This guy's gonna come back this way as well. If I use 5 power to do a cloak here, I can go here, attack it, and then stim, where stim is cloaking, and then go through here. I guess that's fine. I'm gonna have to break this thing down to a level where alright, so this is gonna deal 2, break this thing down by 2, and then I'd have to use like 3 firewall or 3 lockpicks on it, so that's gonna be 3 times 3 possibly, so that's like 9 power. Unless, well, 9 power, 6 power if I use seed on it. 6 power for seed. At that point, I stim and go over here. And once I get over here, actually, I need to see where this guy is probably going to see me if I'm here. I probably need to have her move back over here. Alright, let's start this up. I'm going to start with my attack, because I want to have this thing break using a program, so I get extra power. No exit card. A little unfortunate. Alright, so he can go here. And technically he could probably go over here. Oh, this is gonna cost me 5 power to do this cloak, isn't it? I could also not use the cloak and actually, I pretty much have to use a cloak here. I guess I could use a cloaking rig cooldown here. That'll save me 5 power. But if I did use a cloak, that would mean that I could get over here and then apply one last attack on this thing and then move back here. I think I have enough action points to even peek here. Alright, let's go ahead and cloak. So she's probably just going to be hiding right here. Alright, both these guys should be safe from the eyes of this dude. Okay. So I could open the door here. If I see nothing bad, then I could go inside. See, this guy kind of comes through here. He's not gonna see me right here. This is just a regular unlock, so once I hack this thing, which should be maybe next turn, I should be able to, do that. So I can just move inside here. This guy's gonna move there. I'm gonna move her over. Wow, she can move so far. She can move like, I guess here would probably be the space the best, like right here. So she's gonna probably have to deal with this thing right here. She doesn't have to deal with it. So let's go ahead and double peek again. Pretty sure that there's no one's gonna see me right here. I can still cloak if necessary. I'm gonna take his pass card. Alright, so she moves all the way over here. Like, this is not safe because I think he's gonna go here and turn. I don't think this is safe either because when he steps here, he's gonna see that. I think this is the closest to this door. Technically, yeah, I think this would be spotted. Do I want it to maybe, yeah, I think I want to have these guys be more even in terms of items, because I want one of them to be able to pick both these stacks up if necessary. I guess I'll give him the econ chip back. Maybe the stem? No, not the stem. Okay. Alright, everything looks good. I don't have power. Alright, let's see how this goes. Alright, there's that. There's that. Whoa, what? Oh gosh. That blows. That blows. This guy was a patrol? He looks so much like a stationary guard. Alright, alright. Alright. That's why I have cloaking rigs, I guess. So. He does have, fortunately, he's not like a, just a level 3, he doesn't have armor level 3. But, that being the case, what am I going to do here? I could cloak. Well, no, I am going to cloak. There's no could about it. I am going to cloak here. I might have wanted to get some of these power, actually. I forgot to do that. At least when this guy got alerted, he didn't actually yell loud enough for other guards to come. I'm pretty sure... Okay. So I can go here, get the loots here, and then come back out. I would probably need to double check his... Probably need to double check his thing first. Yeah. So he does turn this way, so this is not going to be bad for me to do that. If I use hammer on this, that'll allow me to get some more action points. Hammer, I could drop down like an EMP right here. Cloak, drop down EMP right here. Even go towards like here. And, I don't have enough power to do that. So this is at 5. I'm going to use... Well... I could technically use, like... Could technically use hammer here. Double lockpick here. I don't have enough power for double lockpick. Alright, do I have any cooldowns on me? I don't have cooldowns, but I could hack this thing for power. So go over here, hack this thing for power, hide over here. If this guy goes here and hacks this thing down to 3, double cooldown that. No, that doesn't work. I guess I just want to hammer this thing. This is my guess. Alright, so now he's probably just gonna go here first, get power, and then maybe go rep to here. I'm actually pretty close to being finished with this. So get power here, rep. Well, no, she gets the power. He just goes over here and gets himself into position to steal or to pick up the portable server. What is this, turn four? Okay. I'm wrapping up this mission pretty darn quick, I think. This guy that was on the long patrol path, he's actually gonna be, I'm probably gonna cloak by him in all likelihood. Actually, he might not go into this room, he might just patrol over here. Alright, so I have enough to double lockpick this thing. Not sure why I want to do this so quickly, but I feel like I do. This should give me the... Still no pass card, okay. Man, this sucks right here. I can cloak. He's probably gonna. Let me think about this. If I cloak, go here, drop an EMP, then go here. He's gonna go here. He's gonna hear the EMP go off and go to this spot. If I drop an EMP here, he's gonna go to this spot. Actually, you know what? I probably want to drop the EMP such that it hits both him and this area that I'm headed to.
Damn it! They got away.
Warning.
Thanks. Cannot move there. What? Oh shit. Alright. Still close enough to drop the EMP. Guess I still have a lot of movement to go. Wonder what's in here. Okay. Level 5. If I use two hacks here, I'll be able to bring this thing low enough such that the EMP will knock it down. Alright, she could actually move all the way back here and get power, and then even go back here. Alternatively, she could head over here, get power, and okay, so at this point I'm not sure that he'd hear the EMP. Would I want to like peek inside here? So looking at the EMP range, it could be that I want to move closer over here before I EMP. I don't necessarily, I don't think I need to, I don't think I need to have him be distracted by it. Yeah, as long as it hits him. So I can even move a little further out. I'm almost certain. I'm almost certain that I need, I'm gonna have to EMP something inside this room. So I'm gonna drop it here. I do need to bring that lower.
There's the lockbox. Even if we can't use the contents, we can sell them.
Even with the, wait, oh fuck. I need to close that door. So I need 3 more power in order for me to bring this down to 2. And bring, yeah, so I need to have 3 activations of lockpick here. So maybe go here, get power, and then come over here. At that point, I can possibly next turn. Oh boy, if this guy hears this thing. Oh yeah, I shouldn't go back and close this door. Alright, there we go. Alright, so I'm good here. Get power here, and then I think I stay here. He should be here for a turn. Yeah. Fairly confident in that. Wait. Oh shit. I screwed up there. I should have gone right here. Fuck. Technically. Oh, that was such bad. That was so bad. Because this guy's gonna actually see me when he does this turn. He's gonna see me right there. What to do here? Okay, so what I can do is get 8 power there. That gives me up to 14, so I can break someone's barrier, and maybe that'll be enough for some extra action points. For instance, this guy. Sweet. So I can probably move like over here. Guess I just want to be a little more careful and just move right there. Alright. So let's bring this thing down so that the EMP is going to break that. Bring this one down as well. Peek here. Are you fucking serious? Oh my lord. This guy's gonna see me right here. Is that good? Is that true? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Actually, I think he doesn't see me because he doesn't have that far of a range. I'm fairly sure the range is also 8. Well, we'll see about here. Yeah, that looks fine, that looks fine. I guess I could technically move her into this room. Like, move her right over here. Whoa!
Hey, intruder! What was that?
Oh. Fuck. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. This girl is a dead girl. Don't have cloak for her. No, I... Oh, fuck. Okay, so let me think about this. Do I have any cooldowns? I mean, if I had a little more power... If I had a little more power, I could possibly hand off... I could possibly get the cloak over to her and cloak her. but she's probably gonna die. Man, that was such a fuck up. Okay. That being the case, what to do here? Oh gosh. All these guys are gonna be alerted. Okay, so I still have my stim here. I could drop an EMP for what it's worth. What is an EMP worth? An EMP worth like a couple down on this thing, couple down on this thing. Maybe. Not that. No. Man. I fucked that up so badly. I should have known that this guy was there too. I saw his pathing. I just thought his pathing meant that he was like over here. Alright, so... Alright, whatever. I'm probably not going to be able to use that at any point. It should still be alright.
Investigating area. Operator,
be more careful with our assets.
Investigating area. What was that?
That got their attention. Don't be there when they arrive.
So many fuck ups. This should be just empty, I think. Okay, yeah. Okay, so I can get to here next turn, get that. Almost certainly that has the card, actually. Let me think about that. I guess it has the card, or. If it doesn't have the card, then this would have the card in it. I'm gonna have to buy. I'm gonna have to buy a med gel probably. If this does have the card, then I'm not gonna be able to get it without like dropping something. Does she also have my econ chip? Okay, good. Yeah, these guys are just gonna pin me forever for days. Alright, I think it's time to pick up some of these things. Well, let me think about that actually. These guys are gonna start tracking. These three are starting to start tracking. This, okay, no, four. Is it possible for me to just drag this guy? I do have improved drag, so. And also I have a lot of stim, so the dragging can go pretty darn fast. It might be better than getting a med gel. Also, it means I really didn't have any costs associated with it. Alright. Do I need power? I'm gonna say probably not. It's even possible that I want to keep some of these things up so that I can have one turn where I'm just breaking a lot of things. If I put, like, hack this. So if I pick up the servers now, I'm gonna get no power generation for the next couple turns. Let me see about this. I wanna tag this guy. I also wanna tag that guy as well. Most likely I can get power here, I guess. So I can just pick it up, yeah. Alright, I already tagged this guy, yeah. What am I thinking? So what happens here? What happens here? There's no EMP. There's no even possibility of an EMP here. If I pick up this, I can go to like here maybe. Again, that's pretty unlikely that they see me. I think what I would want to do is I want to tag the last dude that I haven't tagged. This dude I have tagged, this dude I have not tagged yet. Okay, so now I know where all of them are going. Alright, this guy is gonna go over here. Alright. Yeah, am I comfortable with picking these up? Yeah, I'm comfortable picking these up because I'm gonna probably get power over here. Yeah. Could have been so easy if I hadn't effed it up. So here, I can actually stay right there. Since this guy's going to turn that way. Ooh, you know what? If I open and close this door, this guy is, instead of going to pin my dude, they're actually gonna not pin it, and maybe I can have them revive in a couple of turns. Yeah, how about that? Unfortunately, if I open and close this door, it also means that this guy is gonna go here. But I think I can play around with that. At some point I might be able to shock trap him. Because otherwise I think he just stays on top of my dude.
What was that? Investigating.
Yeah. Yep. Good. Who has my Yeah, this econ chip is never gonna do anything. Okay, that looks fine, that looks fine. And I'm good with that. Wait, what?
Investigating area. You ain't hiding from me. Investigating.
Oh, I fucked that up. I should have closed that door. I should have left that door open. This guy, I had a sense that this guy was actually coming this way. Maybe that was... Alright, that guy's... Wait, did I even use my seed last turn? I might F that up, yeah. I'll use seed. I might use seed here. Okay, so I'm gonna drag this girl over. She's gonna actually wake up next turn, I believe. This guy's over here. Wait, is she down? Oh, she is down. They didn't knock her out, that's right. That being the case, I could still drag her. Instead of buying a med gel. But this is kind of moment of truth. Is this gonna overload me? Oh shit, this guy's gonna come in this room. He's not gonna come in this room, he's gonna get knocked out. Go here, place a knockout trap. Guess I could also go an overwatch here. Go on Overwatch here and knock him out. They'll place this thing on cooldown for 7 turns, but I could also. That also means I have my shock trap ready. Which one is more important? Shock trap to cooldown or disruptor cooldown? I can't imagine myself using Shock Trap very well in this scenario. 3. Alright, I'm gonna probably just ambush him. I should have left that door open. I don't know what the hell I was thinking there. So the question is, do I want to maybe play around in shadows and have so I could get him to even be over here or here. Oh no, let's see, I can get him to be over here. Yeah. and then have him kind of drag her to this corner. I don't need to steal anything from her. She doesn't have any she doesn't have any stim either, that I don't think. Yeah, she doesn't have any stim that's useful right now. Yeah, so I think I will distract this guy over here for a turn or two. I can get him all the way over here actually. Like open and close this door right here. No, I can't, because I'd have to move back through here. I don't want him to be standing here. Well, do I not want him to? Let's see. If I get him to be over here, he's gonna be. Is he gonna go in diagonal? Yeah, he's gonna go diagonally right here. At that point, I'm gonna sneak by, going through this zone right here, and then probably getting here next turn. Okay, so getting him.
What was that?
Fuck. Alright, so that didn't go as planned. If he looks straight here. Actually, yeah, he's gonna see this right here. So I think I want him to go here instead. What the fuck, man? Okay, yeah, he's gonna go there. Alright, and him, he can drag this body. I mean, he can still cloak. What?
Looking around.
He went back? Oh my. Why is this so hard? Oh my gosh. Oh my lord. Why didn't I just shock trap him? Fuck. Alright. So I can't knock him out when he's just looking straight at me. What the fuck do I do here? So, looks like I stim, get over here, knock this guy down. Alright. Do I need a stim? I'm guessing no. I can even not be in this. I guess it doesn't matter here actually, because he's gonna go through this spot anyways. Okay. Just go over here, buster chip him. Buster chip and kill him? Oh my gosh. Buster chip and kill him unless I somehow transfer his weapon, like his dart weapon, over to her. Alright, let's go ahead and... Okay, so I drag... I drag her to this safe spot. No, I guess she's dead, so he's not gonna even care. I move him over here. Give the disruptor over to her. And I should be able to move back to here, maybe. Okay, so exchange the disruptor to her, or pass her the disruptor. I could stem, I could drag. I wonder if this guy would actually spot this thing and do something weird. I don't think I have enough movement points to actually worry about that, though. Alright. On the positive side, the econ chip is going to be up. Can get one more econ chip use. So yeah.
What was that? Investigating.
Fly spin. Break down his. Wait, what? Oh, fuck. He's level 4, isn't he? Wow. Oh, right, so his barrier was down last turn. He just wasn't gonna budge from it. Can't kill him either, because I don't have enough armor piercing. It's level 3. It's level 3. No, what the fuck? Why can't I buster ship this guy? Because he's an Overwatch or something? Oh, I didn't open the door? Alright, I closed the door on myself. At this point, does it matter? Yeah, I still want to just use the buster chip here. Alright, so this guy, so I could go back to here, which is nothing great. I could hack this so that I get some more action points here. So let's go ahead and hack this thing. Unfortunately, that does still not give me enough. Hack this thing. Alright, that gives me enough. Oh shit, I probably should have moved her first. Whatever. She's gonna move over here. She's gonna move like all the way over here. Alright, this thing is not good because he's gonna do a sideways search here. This thing's fine. This thing might be fine too, if I really want to push it. But I think I'd probably just want to be right here. And then next turn, go over here. He's gonna... I guess Deckard just does want to actually get the econ chip usage here. And if need be, he'll stim or cloak. Yeah, that's not safe. So let's go ahead and just go. Just stay here. This will be safer. Alright, so this thing has my thingamabobber. I should have transferred. No, I don't have actually. I don't have any inventory spots.
Target down. Investigating area.
Oh, he does go to pin it.
Alarm level two.
Okay. Good to know.
Data security enhanced.
Alright, so he does go to pin it. I'm not sure if he sees this this location here. Alright, so this guy's coming back. I think I might have to peek here. Okay, so I could just knock him out, but that's not gonna be... Okay, so I could actually just go right up to him, get ready to like drag, or I could, heaven forbid, buy a med gel. Who actually has the inventory space for a med gel? So she gets here, she buys a med gel. I go here and knock this guy out. This is 4-0, there's 2-KO for the alarm, so... I could even just go here and knock him out and like, then start dragging this body. I have just a ton of stems anyways. What would I use to actually knock him out? I use her. Go knock him out. Drag the body. Alright. Let's go ahead and do that. I could also just leave him be. I'm not gonna be able to go very far this turn. I haven't stolen from him, really? No, okay, I have stolen from him. Alright, so he's just gonna walk over here. And then next turn, I can start dragging her over here. Oh shit, did I forget to really do that? Okay. Let's go ahead and break. Put parasite in this thing. And then... Whatever, put parasite in this thing. Oof. Good thing this is sump cover, I believe. Where is this guy going next? Alright, so this guy's going further there. Technically, let me see. Like, go here, drag it. I can. Let's go ahead and drop something here. Like. Well, no, let's drop both items. Have her be overburdened. Now drag this thing like all the way up to here and have someone else continue the drag. And I should be able to get, yeah, perfect. Okay, next turn, I'll probably knock down this guy somehow. Or I can just be silly and just like totally go around him. Yeah, he's just gonna go this way. So here I can cloak. No, I'm just gonna drag this thing. This is silly. I'm gonna just knock him out. Can I get this girl all the way to the exit if I do? She has enough stems, I think. He has enough stem for her. Oh, just gonna kill my power, isn't it? Whatever. I probably need to stem myself here. Was not pretty, but when you have so many items, it's pretty hard to screw up. Completely. Alright.
The more equipment we recover, the more tactical options we have in the field.
I agree, Central. Wow, that was so messy. At least I didn't have to buy a med gel. Yay. Alright, so that's a wrap. Day 11, I'm not sure that there's any difference at this point from what you've seen before. So I'm probably gonna take a pause, maybe. If you guys have any suggestions as to what you might want to see, I might do some more horse zone. I might do something. Well, we'll see. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.